Alright, this time I'm gonna announce that I am going specialist, just so everyone knows what's up. What about baby rock? Please don't talk to me about baby rock. Sounds so bad. Alright, here's my options.
Greetings, friend.
Is it specialist day because you want to spam Murky as much as possible, Kappa?
Guilty as charged. It's not just Murky though. I think it's my favorite class in general. So it's Murky, it's Medivh, Vikings, whatever is appropriate. Why is that text so fancy? Is that a feature? What text? Don't play Zul, please. Hey, I know Zul is not the most aggressive hero, but with the Scarecrow skin, it's quite a nice compensation, isn't it? I love Murky, would like to see a game of it. Well, let's see if we can make that happen. Try Danielson.
I thank you.
Thanks for the sub, Bulgarian.
Yesterday, I had a ranked match with 3 assassins and 2 supports.
Sounds good.
Against 2 tanks, 2 assassins, and 1 support. Because I used Dickus and had a Tyrand Go DMG build, we won.
Damn the G's.
Anything is possible.
Yeah. I don't know the exact statistics of, you know, that being, you know, the exact win rate of that, but I would never give up as long as I have a support. The worst thing in Heroes of the Storm is lack of support. Lack of warrior, surprisingly, is okay fairly often. The same way you just did, Mr. Paladin, when you used the double square bracket, it automatically makes it a clickable category. HTX Kushi says, I was wondering how does vulnerability work with damage skills that deal percentage-based max HP, like Zul's Bone Prism and Karset Blades. As far as I know, vulnerability and armor do not affect percentage-based HP damage. I don't know what you're talking about, Mike fam, but please don't spam the chat like this. Yes, it's a new mic, Xsteel. I'm still testing it, but this is a new microphone. Alright, do I want Murky against Valeera Kerrigan? Maybe yes. Murky... Gazlo's just gonna get ganked. Abathur's pretty nice. I could do Zul.
Greetings, friend.
Hammer, Medivh. Medivh is pretty nice here, actually. We can't Murky after Ragnar's second frontliner. I agree with that. I think this is a good Medivh.
Hey, Grubby and chat. Thanks for your comments about the tool. There are improvements and new variables I will include in the future, like maps. Still, it chooses decent heroes. By the way, awesome stream.
Thank you very much, dear Rip. And as soon as it adds a map, please link it to me again and I'll see if I can use it. Without map, I feel like it's just slightly too limited in its utility for me. Though it's a really good start, I think. I'm guessing it's basing it off of win rates. See ya, Mighty Cat. Grubby, how old are you? 17.
Whoop whoop.
Whoop whoop. Chabba Chaps, thanks for the resubs. 3 months. It looks awesome. Grats on the new mic. You sound very nice as well. Well, thank you, Xsteel. Should be great the next KVK or raid. It was actually 3 things coming together that lead to the new microphone. Without me asking for it, ROG sent me this new microphone to test it out and give feedback.
I will fight to
secondly,
my last breath.
The microphone that I was using had some static pops, And thirdly, the microphone I was using picked out pretty roughly. When I speak very loudly or shout or laugh, it was a bit painful. Yeah, I'm 17 too. Nice. Good access. Fake news. Alternative. I won WCG when I was 8, yes. Oh, don't ruin it, Okami Rain. Don't expose me.
Prepare yourselves for battle, heroes.
Okay. Looks like a pretty good draft. We've got kind of like... Wait, that was weird. We've kind of got like 1.5 support, Medivh counting as half. His category is Burst Protect, which they have a lot of, Valeera and Kerrigan.
The battle begins in
Wait, why is he going top when I click here? What the hell? This is a new bug. This is 100% a new bug. Normally he goes to the closest point that he can not pass. Thanks for your opinion, Agap. See you.
There is much at stake. Thank you, hero. The time will go short. Away with you. There is much at stake.
Would have been nice if I force of willed someone else that was actually getting hit, but she made it look like she's going for me. The selfish force of will. Hey, Klaus. So I can't read too much chat because I want to focus on doing a legit gameplay.
Thank you, healer. I will deal with you myself.
It is done.
Though we didn't get a kill, we did good damage.
Defeat its guardians, and the Punisher will be ours.
For the sake of our future.
Is Anubra good for that gun? Not bad. Though maybe not 1v5.
My destiny awaits.
You will not stand in my way.
I will endeavor to return.
Pretty good damage. Maybe I should have used portal. Their auto attack damage is Falstad, Valeera, Kerrigan is pretty good. Tyrael has decent auto attack damage. Their spell damage is combo, all her combos, and Falstad's boomerang. I would say it's 50-50 spell and auto attack, so I would say that Anubarak is actually pretty good here. Though I think maybe Beetle... Nah. Beetle build against Kerrigan is so-so. She can use the Beetles to juke and heal.
Punisher has been summoned by the burning hells.
Funny, the boss went into the other direction. I went for Dust of Appearance, by the way. As opposed to... Not Dust of Appearance.
You will not stand in my way.
As opposed to the Raven Vision.
Well must retreat.
I see visions and nightmares. I will endeavor to return the favor.
Such daring!
For Azeroth!
Yes!
For the sake of our future.
To hell.
I was not deep or anything, was I? Shh, we're listening to Diablo music. Was it greedy? I think I could have done it. If I executed a bit better. Outplayed? Not really, I outplayed myself.
There is much at stake.
Ragnaros.
Your time has come.
Double kill.
Nice.
Hail before my might.
For the sake of our future.
For Azeroth.
I will deal with you myself. I see visions, nightmares. Onward. Thank you, healer. Of course.
Head to a healing fountain.
Winds of change are howling.
Nope.
An arcane punisher comes for you.
I can't get three skeletons, so it would not be safe.
The enemy's punisher has been vanquished.
Wow, Gargantuan is doing a huge number. So 1.3 levels down, 311 in takedowns. I need to take better care of Ragnaros, his 5 deaths. Yeah. Oh, we have Wet Blast. Good evening, Grubby. You made me popular with that analysis. I'm also finally back to Diamond. Oh, that was you. Desaria? Kanata? Nice, congrats.
For the sake of our future.
I just want to stay on them and reveal their rotations. What rank am I in Hero League? I'm like 3,700 points.
Our forge is lost.
Great shadow looms.
Greetings, friend.
You will not stand in my way.
Thank you, healer.
I can't attack her back, baby Rash.
For the sake of our future. Thank you, healer.
Got it, so we better get out.
A frozen punisher moves against us.
There's much at stake.
Oh shit. Oh, why did it go back in?
Thank you.
What are you doing?
Now. How many stacks do I have? 30 already. Oh, good.
One of our foes has fallen.
Great shadow. I will endeavor to return the favor.
Oh no, he killed me too. Well, we killed four. It's okay, and I have my quest.
My life is a small price to pay.
So, I think I need to save Ley Line Seal 100% of the time for sanctification. What do you think? Because it counters it. And vice versa. It's the same with Void Prison.
Greetings, friend.
Thank you for your entertaining and informative stream. Worth every cent, less than three.
Thank you, BK. Thank you very much. And Mauritius as well. I'm just going to go with the team. It's not worth splitting to defend the split push when we could just die here instead. You can leyline people in Sanct, yeah. Yeah. Same with Void Prison. Time stop effects are quite something else.
I will deal with you myself. Fate waits for none of us. Healer.
Away with you.
Fate become clearer.
Do I talk about my talent choice after this game? Yeah, sure. After the game.
It is time I returned to our friend. Core.
We need the female voice back. That was her thing.
It was. And now it's not.
I see visions and nightmares.
I guess they get the thing again.
There is much at stake.
Greetings.
What do you do?
I bet I get paid more than the female voice too.
Oh, check your privileges.
I will set things right.
What did he just do? Did he just say gold? Gold, Ragnaros. I was just gonna force the will too. Oh, that's a lovely Sanct. Well done. I knew he's probably sharking on me, but I gotta tell you guys, I don't see Valeera cloak all that well. Compared to the others, she's always next to me when I don't expect. Is it because she has ambush? No, she's not using that, is she? Oh, she does use it. This rag is out of position a lot. Yeah, well, we'll just try to do our best. He's doing his best, everyone is. Unfortunate that we decide to chase 4v5. I don't know quite the tactic behind that.
Time to make my retreat.
Survivor's Guild, decide to use my portal.
Fate waits for none of us.
At least we've got like a nice push on the keep. It opened it up, kind of. I might have to go for the Terrisful Guardian at 20 to stop some of their push. So I can insta-gip minion waves. Could also do Medivh's cheats.
Murdered by my closest friends. Your fate will be much worse. Yours is a transparent stratagem. Fate waits for none of us.
And play with blood. Show its guardians your resolve.
Iridor Ignar.
It's so good that he can taunt while he's in Raven mode. Probably one of the best things about Medivh.
Fate waits for none of us.
Once Nazebo gets 20, we're gonna get some pretty nice damage. Take the portal, bruh.
Be warned, the frozen punisher has been set against us.
He He doesn't take the portal even when it's perfect.
My destiny awaits.
Nice buying time. Nice, Valeera. But that was not bad.
Your time has come.
Meteor. Okay. Let's see. I might just get the instant kill. Ten 10% ability power is pretty good too. Maybe I save it for a bit. We'll see what we need once we come out. She do so much damage. I drop instantly from full to nothing.
I will endeavor to return the favor.
I'll get Medivh cheats finally.
The shrine is ready. Go and claim the Punisher's power for the high heavens.
Worth it. Oh, that game. Very good, Valeera. GG, Mr. Banner Bear. Bad game for me, but no one blamed him. He didn't go into cry mode either. You can always have a rough game. And we managed to do it anyway. Nazebo late game carried. We all soldiered on. And we made it work as a team. That was awesome. So difficult. Whew. Nazebo level 20, not bad. Alright, let's do a talent review. Josh Danielson. You wanted me to say. I meant to say try Danielson. I know you so well by now. Alright. So, I go for stable portal. It goes from 6 to 9 seconds. It definitely beats out the additional movement speed on the additional mana regen. You just need 9 seconds to have the proper utility. Portal mastery is cool, but again, it's only 6 seconds. It's not good enough. Dust of appearance because of Valeera. Now, this one has a longer cooldown than the Raven bigger area. But you actually, it sticks to them. Wherever they go, you follow them for 10 seconds. Very powerful. Master's Touch is the best for DPS. Leyline Seal to interrupt Sanctification usage. And when they do their big all-in. Quickening, so you can use it more often to save yourself. Reabsorption, so that you can time it on a Kerrigan Burst or a Valeera Burst combo. Or even on Thunderstrikes from Falstad. And it's going to get some guaranteed heals. Though I will say that Reabsorption does the best against mages. Kel'Thas, Li Ming, and Chromie, Reabsorption gets a lot of value because they have telegraphed spells. You can go for other talents as well. I think all Force of Will talents at 16 are good, but this one seems pretty nice. Level 20, as you could see, was a difficult choice, but I decided to go for this one. Not just for the redirection, because people like to dodge it, but also for the increased duration. Allows people to set up easier. Another cool thing is that Time Stop also stops people's cooldowns. And your own cooldowns keep ticking down and get regenerated. So even if Void Prison and Leyline Seal did nothing in terms of wombo combo, just stopping their cooldowns would be a very powerful ability already. Valeera went for Subtlety.
Greetings, friend.
Additional energy.
Best.
Thanks, P squared. Additional energy generation after being stealth for a while. And then more combo points. And an ambush deals more damage if you isolate someone, which he did a lot, and I felt it, it was painful. Then the teleportation, ambush has 7 range. There's no stun or silence, but you saw that she kept using the damage component. I dropped from 100% to 30%, just like that, because of the assassinate death from above combo. It also means that she's never in range of my Q. Q has about range 6, she can go from range 7, literally point and click from stealth. I do think that the stun build from Valeera is potentially more powerful, just because the target cannot react. But this was a nice new usage of the different talents. Expose armor. Okay, so he eviscerates me after he ambushes on me, making me lose armor. And then finally cold blood, more damage as well. So this was a burst build. Energy and burst, not about lockdown or something like that. And she did pretty well with it. 9 kills, 2 deaths, 85,000 damage. Someone said, don't look at that Valeera build, it's bad. It's not the going one, I know that. I wouldn't say it's bad. This player played pretty well, so I think maybe open mind is better. I'm gonna take a short break. Kind of reconnect with chat, because actually I don't get to talk a lot during the game, do I? I want to give a shout out as well to Anubarak, who did a pretty cool playstyle. First of all, picking Anubarak in that situation. And secondly, I think he played pretty nice. He kept himself alive pretty well.
You're holding back. Double kill.
Threatening a burrow charge. That feel when you hit all your stabs. Feel good, man.